Okay, guys, I'm going to run through how to make the color card. So by now, I think it's easier to do this after your print is indexed and you're kind of settled on what colors are actually in your print. So you can go ahead and open up your color table. So you do that by image, mode, color table. And you'll start by pulling these colors to put on your color card. Now, my print is, it's a cool print. It's not a warm print, right? It's not very neutral. It just has the cool blues and purples and whatnots in it, maybe pinks. So obviously I'm gonna have blue, purple on my color card, but we don't want my color card for my entire collection to just be cool colors. So you're gonna have to pull warm colors and neutral colors and add them to your color card. And I'm being pretty loose with this. I suggest maybe going to your inspiration board and pulling colors from that to create your color board. You guys can really do anything you want. The only thing that I'm going to be mandating is how you organize your color board. So I'm going to go ahead and start. So like with this one, I'm probably going to say I'm going to have a shade of pink. I'm gonna have a shade of purple, I'm gonna have a shade of dark blue, and I'm gonna have a shade of turquoise. So I'm gonna pull four colors from this artwork and put them on my color card. And then the other colors, I feel like they're just different shades of those like four hues that I'm gonna call out. So let's say this first little light pink one, I know, I guess he's kind of light purple. I want him on my color card. So how we're going to do this is, let's see here. Well, first of all, you're going to make your color card in Illustrator. So you'll open up an Illustrator file. I recommend doing landscape and then make some squares. If you hit the keyboard shortcut, the letter M, it opens up the square tool. Now, when you make your shapes, they should be a perfect square. So if you hold down shift, that should allow you to do that. Or you can always right click. Oh, just kidding. I was going to say, yeah, if you right click, you can type in like, maybe, you know, you want them 1 inch by 1 inch. Up to you, however you, what shape you want or what size, you'll figure it out. Okay. So you're going to have, you know, a few of these, ready to go. I think I said like between 10 to 15 color chips. I can't even remember, but you know, anyways, these do need to be evenly spaced out. It's okay if they're in more than one row, that's fine. But you know, to space them out, you're gonna wanna use the align tool. It's up here at the top. And this one right here, this will space out. Okay, but I should only have one row. Here we go. Align, it'll distribute the space evenly. So, and then you also want them aligned. So you can, either one of these three buttons at the top will line them up. They already are aligned, so nothing really happened there. And so then I'll just like pull these down. So I'll let you guys, you know, play around with the exact format. Again, we're all probably gonna have different amount of color chips. Okay, so you'll also add a header to this document. And then on this document, you're gonna add the Pantone number and you're gonna name each color chip. Okay, so let's just get started with the first one. If I want, I could copy this little web number. I'm gonna hit Command C to copy. I'm gonna come over here in Illustrator. I'm gonna double click and I'll paste it just so I have it ready to go. Okay, now I'm gonna go back to Photoshop. What's cool about Photoshop is that they have color libraries. I'm not sure why Illustrator doesn't have it, but they have Pantone numbers in their libraries. They don't have the textile one, as far as I know. I'm not seeing it. Maybe, I don't know, I don't really see it. So I usually use the Pantone solid coated, just to start with. So they're suggesting that, according, like on my computer, they think the closest chip is 250C. Okay, that's fine. So what I do is then, I go to Pantone's website. Okay. And I choose find a Pantone color. And then I type in 250C and I hit return. And I wait. Okay, so here we go. This is the color chip. Now, if I click on it, it's Pantone 250C. It doesn't have a color name, which is fine. I can come up with my own color name. That's totally fine. Or you can copy Pantone's color names if you want. So there's a couple things. It doesn't have the name. Not a big deal, we're creative, we can make up one. But it's also really in the wrong family of what we want, because this should be printed on like some kind of textile, like, you know, maybe like cotton or whatever, where this type of Pantone, I think it's more geared towards like screen printing inks, so it's a little bit different. So what we can do, I can go back to the other tab and we can say convert Pantone to Pantone. And we can say, you can choose all the different libraries. So this is for fashion, textiles, and soft home, the TCX. That's probably what you want. I would recommend clicking that and then type in your 250C and hit return. Okay, ours is C, there it is, this is the color. So here they are saying this is the best match. They even gave us some other alternatives as well. So, you know, you can kind of look at it. Do you like this bright one or do you think the more like shaded, kind of dirtier one is better? You know, you can really choose. That's up to you what color you want to choose, if you want to just stick with what they recommend or not. Let's say for some reason I love alternative number 4. I'm going to use that guy. Oh, and it's gone. Ooh, dearie. Let's try again. Okay, it's back. It's back. So then I can use this as my Pantone number instead of 250C. TCX, again, it's, I feel like when I use the C's Pantones, that's for like screen printing ink. That's for like Plastisol ink. That's what I've been taught. Where TCX is more for like the dye that you use to like dye fabric. Like think like Rit dye or whatever. It's more, so it's just a different formula. It's not a big deal. If you want to do the C's on your color card, I don't have a problem with it. But just students always ask me about this, so that's why I'm trying to explain it. So anyway, so I'm going to use Pantone TCX. And then if I'm not feeling creative, I'll just copy their name, Pink Tool. So for some reason, the TCX library, they got names with all the colors. In the C one, they didn't get names. Whatever, it doesn't matter. We can always come up with our own name. So I'm going to copy that. I'm going to come over to Illustrator. I'm going to paste it. Paste it as a text file. That's great. You might want to change the font or whatever and figure it out. But just format it, you know, so it looks nice. Yeah. Maybe we want this guy to be aligned in the center. We can do that. Maybe it's actually better to have the name on the top. Possibly, and then the Pantone number. Maybe the name is in bold, so we can open up window, the type character window, kind of play around with that. Oopsies. Okay. Let's see here. It's right now it's regular. Oh, regular's the only option apparently. If I change to a different font, maybe then I can change it to, oh. Wow, I guess I only get to pick regular. I guess I need to find a font that's bold for that to work. But anyways, again, the font and everything, I recommend keeping it simple, keeping it easy to read and clear. But yeah, but you can do whatever font you want that you think looks nice. So this is basically it. I'm going to call out my color chips. You guys can choose whatever color chips you want, but I do recommend including warm colors, cool colors, and neutral colors on your color card. So it'll be easy to pull from your artwork, but you're probably also gonna have to get some other colors on your color board as well. And I'm leaving it up to you to figure out how to do it. Once you have your color card kind of all sorted, then you can go back to Photoshop and you can recolor two additional colorways. So, you know, right here I have my cool colorway. I probably want to work on some kind of warm colorway. And then probably a neutral one, you know, maybe like a black ground one of some sort. So that's what we're doing. Let's see here. That's basically it. If you guys have questions about this assignment, go ahead and reach out and let me know. And yeah, I'm excited to see all your different colorways of your art.